So apparently the way you copy 100 files onto an SD card is to select them one by one and copy them individually. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Reddit. Actually, thank you, Michael Guy, for pointing me to the subreddit. I will link it below. It's hilarious, especially if you're into actual technology, if you're into programming, software, hacking, anything to do with actual like computer technology, and the way that, if you're interested in the way that Hollywood misrepresents it, you'll love that subreddit. Speaking of, I was particularly thinking of my friend Jemimus, who is a database administrator, and he's always like harping on that kind of stuff. And here's the thing. One of my favorite movies is Hackers, okay? And that movie is ridiculous. Ridiculous. But for me, it kind of represented this weird zeitgeist movement that happened in the 90s that I, you know, in a way that we thought internet culture was going to go, and we were going to be like so cool and free and like just out there, and we felt like there was so much possibility, and it's hilarious. It's just hilarious. All the lines, like my best friend and I just quote it up and down. Love Hackers. However, this movie presents a problem on multiple levels for me. The trailer came out and I sat there and I watched it and I thought about it all day long. And I think one, my feelings about the Snowden issue in particular clouded a lot of my ability to just straight up talk about the trailer without just going straight into the Snowden issue. So my thinking here is that if I were to actually just break down the trailer and look at it, kind of just looks like this cheesy espionage thriller. I'm not really sure what they were going for here. I know that they're trying to represent the story, but again, I think they just kind of took the basic premise and are not really addressing any of the real issues. And I feel like if you watch the documentary called Citizen 4, it's pretty thrilling, actually, in itself, the actual truth. And when I compare it to the trailer, I'm just sort of like, the trailer's just, it's way too Hollywood. It's just, it's a little too cheesy. And then I love Joseph Gordon-Levitt, I really do, but there's something really off with his accent here. And I know he's doing his best to impersonate the accent of Edward Snowden, but Edward Snowden actually has a weird likability to the way he talks. And the way that Joseph Gordon-Levitt plays him, he just seems very dry, and he just doesn't seem very engaging. And actually, when you listen to Edward Snowden talk, surprisingly, he does sound a bit engaging. The acting also seems a little bit over the top in some parts. there was Nicolas Cage, who I don't think he has another way of acting, which I thought actually was kind of hilarious seeing him in this, because you sort of like, you see Nick Cage in a movie now, and you're just sort of like, can I take this movie seriously? I don't know. And, Zachary Quinto, I like him too, but his one major line in this trailer was just a little over the top, and the whole thing just seems a little bit sensationalist, and it is actually, it's a very sensational story of events that actually happened. However, I just don't really feel like it's being told in a serious or engaging manner, and it seems like one of those films we may end up watching. I could end up watching and just liking because it's just so over the top and kind of hilarious. I mean, there's a scene where they're opening up all the data, packages or something like that, and looking at all the data, the metadata that's coming in, and, you're seeing video of a girl undressing, you're seeing Facebook pages, you're seeing someone's dating profile, and then, of course, like, all the, like, tech image, the Hollywoodification of tech data just coming at you in this crazy visualization. And it's kind of ridiculous, actually, when you think about like how actual data is transmitted and received on those types of ends. I was actually screenshotting the trailer, and there was this moment where it comes up and it's like, oh, Ghost in the Shell is one of my favorite movies. And then, in the little dating profile that you see. And then the guy replies like, are you this pale in real life? It's hard. How do you take a movie like this seriously? I don't really know. However, here's the thing. I take this subject actually very seriously. And this is why I feel like I have to separate the actual trailer review from my actual thoughts on the subject at hand. I've kind of been debating how I feel about Edward Snowden for, ever since the story broke, because a lot of people tout him as kind of like a hero and this great whistleblower. And I have, if you've ever been near or around the intelligence community, you kind of understand like what's at stake. So you don't really take these types of things as like this glorification without looking at all the consequences. And while I do believe that, you know, right to privacy has been violated, a part of me always felt like that had happened after the Patriot Act was signed. And that I kind of knew, I always knew after that, that at any point we would be surveillance. And I actually thought about this when I was way, way younger too. I always thought like people were on satellites watching me at all times. And maybe that's just this crazy paranoia I always had. But I figured if they could, why wouldn't they? You know, especially with the backing of the idea of national security, right? So the fact that this came out didn't really surprise me at all. And then the fact that no one really actually stood up and did anything afterwards didn't surprise me at all either. There is this idea, especially with the internet culture, that we have given up a lot of our privacy. We've given up a ton of our privacy. If you use an app, if you use Facebook, if you use Twitter, if you use Instagram, you've signed away a lot of your privacy. One of my favorite quotes is from the movie Chef, where he goes like, "It's out there, bro. You can't take it back," when like when he tweets. It's just because it is. Once you put it out there, it's out there, and it's free information at that point, in my opinion, because that's just how the internet works. And I don't really, we have never really created an infrastructure otherwise. And data is so important. Data is powerful. It's always used, you know, for us and against us. Do I like the violation of privacy? Absolutely not. Do I think it's an inherent right? I don't actually. And that's the thing about Snowden, is he truly believes that privacy is an inherent human right. And I feel like it is a great right to have, but it has to be earned through your social infrastructure. If you don't stand up for privacy, if you don't call your lawmakers every day demanding you want the Patriot Act revoked, that you demand your privacy, that then you're just kind of sitting by and you're being complacent. And I feel like that's exactly what society has done, is we've become very complacent and we've kind of accepted that these are the terms. So look at this trailer where, you know, Edward Snowden is kind of being glorified as this espionage genius whistleblower guy, and it just, I have a problem with it. I really do. And that's just my personal kind of take on him, which I feel like I didn't want to necessarily share immediately, because it's a very polarizing issue, and if, especially when someone can't speak back to you, and if it's just me giving out my opinion, a lot of people don't feel like they can rebuttal right away, and it just doesn't always seem fair, so it seems like I'm attacking someone's idea. But if I could present it in a way that you can understand where I'm coming from, I see this as a very grave issue. This is kind of an act of treason, right? And this is technically, and stealing national secrets out of a very secure environment with only like one SD card, and who doesn't back up data? Hollywood. But taking that and then leaking that information, you know, exposing tradecraft, exposing the way that we collect data, you know, from a national security agency standpoint, those are all very big things. And I know that a lot of people enjoy WikiLeaks and they think it's kind of funny and they think it's kind of hilarious that the U.S. is being exposed for being an evil entity. But if you are an American, you kind of enjoy a lot of privileges because of these evil entities. And I truly do believe that. And that is one of those topics where I feel like it's more discussion based than just me ranting about it or me just discussing it in a video, et cetera. And that it all kind of ties back into this Hollywood espionage thriller movie. It just frustrates me to no end. Yeah. So anyways, I want to hear your opinion on your ideas of whether or not privacy is an inherent right. I even, you know, my friend Jemimus in the Netherlands, he believes it is an inherent right. And I think that's a great idea. But I feel like if you don't back it up with an actual action, if you don't defend it, if you don't actually create a democracy in which you can actually have impact on your government to decide where the line of privacy is, and especially concerning national security, I think one of the, just off topic a little bit, or not off topic, but a little bit derailing. I actually did listen to Snowden talk about the amount of data, the metadata that's been collected, and how absolutely it's just too much data. And it's actually harmful for the National Security Agency, NSA, because it's just too much data for them to siphon through. And they would be better off actually collecting smart data. And while I don't disagree with that, I still think that data is so powerful, and that's the reason why Google collects it, why Amazon collects it, why Facebook's after it. Everyone is after data because it is so powerful. Because if once you can filter it in the right ways, it's limitless. Do I think our government has that ability? My opinion would be no. That's just my thought. Not yet. Not right now. Not with what they have. But I guess the question really is, or comes down to, if you on the issue, is whether or not you actually believe that this information would eventually be turned on you, right? Because that's the biggest fear. The biggest fear is that we become, you know, this is 1984 and it's Orwellian society in which Big Brother is watching you, controlling us, dictating how we do everything. Luckily, I don't feel like that is the social construct in which we as a society have put the values into. Like, we still value at least an illusory idea of privacy and freedom. But I'm actually doubtful about a lot of that, just concerning how much manipulation the media has over everyone. But that's a whole different subject. All right, so what did you guys think of the Snowden trailer? What do you think about the return of Nick Cage to an A-list Hollywood star? Oh, good old Nick Cage. Or what do you guys think about the actual privacy issue, about national security, about what Snowden did? And have you seen Citizen 4? That's actually, I actually really recommend that documentary. It's super, super good. All right, thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more, you can click right here and watch my review for Ex Machina, or you can click right here and watch my watercolor chat for Are Superheroes Obsolete? Until next time, see you on the flip side.
I'm taking over a TV network.
Finish up, honey, and get to sleep.